Hello guys, this is the Soviet apartment I rented in Murmansk, the biggest northern city in the world, in Russia. But let's start from the beginning, from the street, and then I'll show you the room tour and how much does it cost me.
So guys, I will stay in this five-star building, Soviet building. And let's look around a little bit. Yes, Murmansk, as you call it in English, the biggest northern city in the world, behind the Arctic Circle. No, typical, we have like some kindergarten school there, Soviet panel blocks. And let's enter the building. As you can see, April is tomorrow, but it's still winter here. Yes, heaters everywhere in Russia, so it's warm inside. Yes, but long time no maintenance. Kids screaming. And here will be very interesting moment now. It's written here, don't call here to the cleaning woman. I saw this cleaning lady. She was cleaning here the stairs. So she lives here and works at the same time. Okay, let's enter. When we entered the apartment, Sovietico. It's 30 square meters. Let's take a look around really fast. Quite big kitchen, actually, quite big kitchen. It's like better version of Soviet buildings. But room is quite small, but this is so-called wall, we call it. You see, it's very, in every Soviet apartment, especially late 80s, something, 70s, 60s, you could see this kind of wall. I had it. And of course, the beautiful carpet here. And carpet also over here. All Soviet apartments have carpets. And owner, he like 30 minutes, no, 5-10 minutes told me about the previous owners from Siberia and Ural Mountains. And he even asked me where I'm from, and I said St. Petersburg. Ah, St. Petersburg, cool. So they broke his TV and police don't want to do anything. So he was telling me, oh, how bad situation in Russia and everything. So yeah, but you can see here mountains. They call it Sopki here. Actually, still I gonna ride skis here maybe. Yes, heater, Soviet heater, so it's always warm. Okay, let's go to the kitchen. Here we have the Minsk Atlant refrigerator. Minsk is from Belarus. It's capital of Belarus. They still kind of produce refrigerators, but they, as far as I remember, use some Chinese details, like, or engines. Yes, but I love this kind of Soviet stuff. Actually, I love it. You know, this apartment already, I feel like at home. Yes, this, Beko, hidden heater, water for free, TV, Philips. And let's go to more interesting part now. Ah, it's interesting how to turn on the light here. You see, it's hidden here, but we call it Lampochka Ilyicha, and to the toilet, you turn it on here. He even wrote me in the instruction where to turn it on. Oh, I love your tail. Don't tell Bobby Mancroft about it. He would like Egypt. Yeah, amazing. Oh, this is new. And tubes are new, changed tubes. And here is interesting hidden thing. You can see. Oh, wow, shoes. And coal there. Wow, Soviet. Interesting, what sound does it make? Let's check it out. Yeah, I love it, Soviet style, like in Soviet school. This is we call, I forgot how we call it, but also every Soviet apartment have it. Yes, every Soviet apartment has how called antresoli. So let's check it out, what's there. Fuck, I don't want to break it. Or maybe it's body or someone. Oh, Soviet toilet paper or what? I know it's maybe paper like this. I have a video reviewing Soviet toilet paper, so if someone didn't watch, review it, watch it. Also, I like it that it's Soviet style pillows, not this Western style, like I don't know, but this is with chicken or goose, like you know, they are very soft. So, not bad, guys. What do you think? It cost me 1,700 rubles per day rent. Yes, it's a short rent like Airbnb, but Airbnb is closed in Russia due to sanctions, you know. And we use some Russian websites, but they said it on the website that it cost 1,300, but it's a trick, you know, it's 1,300 if you stay for more than 10 days. Maybe I'll stay here for more than 10 days, but yeah, we'll see. But yes, first I thought maybe to rent some more beautiful apartment, because Soviet apartments, I love them, but girls don't like them. They call it babushka apartments, like babushka maintenance, like repair, you know, apartments. But I thought, fuck it, like, you know, I'm gonna stay Soviet, I'm gonna stay to the roots, and if they don't want, it's their problems. I'll better find some sugar granny, you know. And yes, and it's cheaper, I can save money than those, like, not even fancy, but new repaired apartments, but it's like they put freaking laminate, which I hate, which makes sounds like if upstairs, like, someone live, like, kids, it's like crazy sound. But this is wooden floor, you see, classic. If you fall it, they don't hear it downstairs, but if it's laminate, they can hear it downstairs. So yes, guys, what do you think about this apartment? Would you stay here in the biggest northern city in the world, behind the iron, not iron curtain, but yeah, behind the Arctic Circle. And actually, guys, this city is about 300,000 people, in Soviet times more people lived here, but people moved to St. Petersburg from here, because you know. And it's pretty expensive city, it's a port city, and prices here are even more expensive than in St. Petersburg. You know, you can stay in the center of St. Petersburg in some hotel cheaper than here, like some simple hotel, 3-star hotel. Or in case of apartments, you know, it's not that cheap city. But also because we have here in Russia, in the far north, salaries usually are higher because they have some extra bonuses for working in the cold areas, you know. And prices, of course, are more expensive as well because of that.